did not inform your insurance company of the
Thank you.
Hey, babe. Good. Listen, I am so sorry, but I can't make dinner. I've got to work late again. Well, I got to meet with legal. That's going to jam me up for certainly the rest of the afternoon. I know it's your birthday. I'm going to make it up to you, I promise. Love you. What were we talking about?
We're talking about your deposition.
Don't worry about me, Debbie. Some small-time lawyer trying to squeeze us is not going to get me to say anything I don't want to say.
I have no doubt about that, but as lead counsel for this company, if you screw up, it comes down on my ass. So why do you say we prep your deposition?
Ah, Christ.
Do you remember dealing with a Mr. Harold Abbott?
William, I have a Casey Patterson on line one.
Take another message, Addie. I'll get back to her this week. Sometime. Keep going.
When opposing counsel asks you about Mr. Abbott, how will you respond?
I am going to respond by saying, as senior vice president of membership and claims, it is my job to review every terminated policy. As a matter of fact, Mr. Abbott was sitting right where you are now when we discussed his appeal.
I don't get it. I've been with this insurance company for over 10 years.
I know, Harold. But unfortunately, when we reviewed your claim, we discovered that you failed to mention a previous condition.
What condition? There was no condition.
It says here you had oral surgery to remove a cyst from your jaw.
This is absurd. I have heart disease. It has nothing to do with some oral surgery I had 30 years ago.
Any type of oral surgery is going to leave scar tissue. Scar tissue can lead to gum disease, and as you well know, gum disease can cause heart disease.
You know what? You're a criminal. You are a goddamn criminal. I paid my monthly premium for 10 years without so much as a cold. And now that I'm actually sick, you're gonna deny my coverage? I have a family!
Those are the rules, Harold.
I'm sorry, but your own actions have caused this.
You just giving me a death sentence. Who's gonna cover me now? You just killed me.
I have family too, so I can empathize with his argument. But basically, the guy lied on his application.
Hey, Will, watch it, Will.
What?
Do you think he did that on purpose?
It wasn't my job to assess what his intentions were. It was my job to check the accuracy of his claim. Look, everybody thinks we're the bad guys. Nobody mentions the millions of people we help every year without incident, or the millions of dollars we donate to charity every year, or all the free clinics we support.
Short answers, Will. Short answers.
The assets for one of history's most notorious serial killers, John Kramer, were distributed. They were mainly in real estate holdings, but in my time researching...
One more question. Who found the error on his application?
The dot pit. They work as a team. If there's a discrepancy to be found in an application, six of them will find it.
Sir, they're waiting for you in the conference room.
Very good. How's it going today, people?
Hey.
Great mystery.
Found two application errors for a chronically ill client. This guy practically lives at his doctor's office. I mean, this could probably save us nearly $200,000 over his lifetime.
Terminator strikes again, huh?
I'll be back in a few hours. Looking good, Hank.